In this video, I'm going to show you how to make a heart-shaped obsidian arrowhead that was used in ancient Greece around 1550 BC. This was very common in the archaeological record both in Crete and the Greek mainland, and it was used right up until the Bronze Age when the V-shaped bronze arrowhead replaced the obsidian arrowheads. And it's neat to see the transition between the Stone Age and the Bronze Age and how the arrowheads were very similar. Later on, they started using different arrowheads, including a socketed arrowhead with a barb on it. And I show how to make these bronze arrowheads in previous videos. But in this video, we're going to do an ancient Greece obsidian heart-shaped arrowhead. Here's what I'll be using to make my ancient Greek heart-shaped obsidian arrowhead. I have a piece of obsidian. I dug out of glass buttes. It's volcanic glass, incredibly sharp. Has been used for making arrowheads for thousands of years. My flintknapping kit consists of a leather pad. A deer antler I'll be using to strike flakes off. Here's a deer antler pressure flaker. I have my Utsi the Iceman style pressure flaker. This was what was used more than 5,000 years ago in northern Italy for making arrowheads. It's just a piece of wood with an antler tip. And then I have some hammer stones. I'll be striking flakes off this larger piece of obsidian and then working those down with the smaller tools. So let's get started. The first thing I need to do is strike off some flakes that will be used to make our arrowhead. When you start breaking open a piece of obsidian like that with a hammer stone, you turn it over and look for a spot where you can start taking off flakes that will run along ridges, a natural weak point on this rock. And what I'm seeing right here is there's a pretty nice spot to start taking off flakes. I'll hold it just right there. And this hammer stone's pretty beat up on this side, so I'm going to use this side. And I'm going to hit it pretty hard right down there and have flakes come off. So you hold it right there. Now I'm into the rock and I can start taking smaller flakes off to make our arrowhead. It's really beautiful stuff. It's a black clear glass here. We'll continue to take smaller flakes off here to make our arrowhead. So I'll just hold it on the ground like that. That's a pretty good piece. Let's get started working on this. We'll start hitting it with the hammer stone and then the antler tools and making a nice arrowhead shape to make our heart-shaped ancient Greek arrowhead. Let's start to thin this piece out a little bit. I have a smaller hammer stone. Hold it firmly against my leg and look at that. That just came right off. That's a beautiful piece there. That can be an arrowhead in itself. I'm just going to start thinning some of those edges here. And continue to thin this piece. Another awesome arrowhead shaped piece that you can make. So as you continue to reduce this rock, you got quite a few arrowheads that you can make when you're done. That's almost clear with a couple black laces through it, and then I have some red obsidian in the middle. So it's multicolored and gorgeous. There's a pretty big ridge running along this that's keeping this piece pretty thick, and I want to thin that out, so I'm going to build up a platform at the end of that ridge and then try to strike it. A lot of times you're going to want to build that platform by scraping it with a rock, and then we're going to hold it firmly and give it a nice strike and see if we can run a flake down that ridge. Awesome. That's already getting a lot thinner and more pieces that we can make into arrowheads. The rock has done a good job at thinning it, but I'm going to now move to my antler billet. It's just a little more appropriate for this stage in the arrowheads because it's a little smaller and I can do a little more precise flake removal. I'm going to start by removing those thin edges again. And just rough shaping our arrowhead. We're trying to get what's called a biface, where we have flakes on both sides and a nice center line we can start shaping into an arrowhead. You can start to see flakes building on each other. So it doesn't take too long before you have a really nice biface that works great for making arrowheads. I have a pretty good flake pattern running along this side, but I'm stalling out and I have a stack right there, a little cliff is what I call it. And what I need to do to get rid of that is I need to start grinding the edges here, and there's a ridge, and I'll strike it here and run that whole ridge off, and then it should be pretty level. So kind of build this up by thinning it out a little bit. Then developing your platform by scraping it with a rock. Let's see if we can't strike it and run a nice flake all the way off to make this nice and thin. Starting to take that away. Perfect. Here's our biface. It's starting to come together really nice. We have flakes across the piece on both sides, and we're starting to develop a center line here that I can grind down and to start taking thinning flakes and shaping this into our arrowhead. It's coming together really good, and I'm going to continue working it like we have been, and then show you what it looks like when we're going to start pressure flaking it. We've worked this piece down where we have it nice and thin, and I'm pretty much done with percussion with this antler. I'm now ready to move to pressure flaking, which is simply taking the tip of our pressure flaker, pushing in and down, and removing flakes. So I'll continue to work the edges, shaping it, thinning it, and driving off flakes here. And then once we have our heart shape, I'll show you how we put in our little notch at the base. It's interesting how this pressure flaker tool is over 5,000-year-old style, and it works great. It was a highly advanced technology back then for making great Stone Age tools, and it still works today. So I have the basic outline shape of my arrowhead. It has a nice skinny point and then the rounded edges. And to finish this heart-shaped arrowhead, we need to do a deep notch. And to do that, I'm going to start with my Utzi the Iceman style pressure flaker and then move to my Deer Antler fine tine pressure flaker. And we'll see how deep of a notch we can put in this. Here's our completed obsidian heart-shaped arrowhead. If you want to learn more about archery techniques used in ancient Greece and see pictures of original obsidian heart-shaped arrowheads and the bronze V arrowheads, click the link in the description below and that'll take you to a website that shows you all kinds of different information about ancient Greek archery.